Hey guys, how's it going? My name is Elias, and welcome back to Terraria, the melee-only challenge. In the last episode, we got some better wings. We got really lucky getting the bee wings. And yeah, we used these wings to defeat the twins. So the last of the mechanical bosses was defeated. And now it's time for us to upgrade some gear before trying to take on Plantera, which is what I would like to do today. We'll see if we get to that. There is a couple things that might stop us, but namely finding Plantera, because that can be kind of a pain. But I have been busy off camera. One, I went to the jungle and mined a bunch of chlorophyte ore, basically used an entire spelunker potion with a mining potion as well, which I want to see. Do I have any more mining potions? I don't think I do, which is unfortunate, because a mining potion would be really, really nice, but doesn't look like I do. We'll take that with us. And do I have any more ichor? Yes, I do. Cool. So we're going to make some more potion-y stuff. Mostly I just want to make more flasks of ichor. And we'll save that. We'll save that. Save these for right now. Put everything else away. So yeah, I have been working between episodes. Just doing a little bit of work in the jungle. I got a bunch of chlorophyte. I got some life fruits, which are also really nice. We need 20 of those in total, I do believe, to get max life. But I also found a guarding anklet of the wind, which we need for the final boots upgrade, as well as some mining pants. Now, last episode, I was talking a little bit about how to upgrade the Excalibur and the Knight's Edge to their true versions. Because that's something we need to do. And unfortunately, well, we're close, but we're not quite there. Knight's Edge, we saw, needs more Souls of Might. So we're going to take on the Destroyer one last time. For now, anyways. And that requires lead. And we can make a Mechanical Worm pretty easily. So that's why I had that stuff. Apparently I grabbed all of the, vertebrates that were in there. And the other thing that, we need for the Excalibur is chlorophyte. Now, I might want to make, really good armor for Plantera, which would be the turtle armor. That's also require a lot of chlorophyte and turtle shells, which it doesn't look like I have any, at least not in there. So yeah, there's some problems, but, finding the Anklet of the Wind, means that we are one step closer to getting, the Terra Spark boots, which I think is the top tier? I don't remember. I don't remember which ones are which, but in order to get that, we're going to need an aglet, and unfortunately aglets are found on surface chests or in the basic crate, so wooden or pearl wood. So hopefully we can get that. That's why I went fishing for seaside crates, because seaside crates have another item we need, which is the water walking boots. Not entirely sure what they're specifically called, but we're gonna open some crates and see what we can get. A little bit of money is nice. Shine potions are nice. We'll just throw everything. Ooh, an enchanted hourglass. That is really nice. So let's go ahead and put whatever we can down. Not hourglass, sundial. Enchanted sundial is a really good item. I don't know where to put it right now. I guess we'll put it right here. This speeds up time by an entire day, but you can only use it, I think, once a Terrarian week. I'm not entirely sure about that. Ooh, iron skin. That's also really nice. Alright, so an anchor. Anchors are actually decent weapons. They are kind of like flails. They do a lot of damage, but not my type of thing. So we get three mithril crates and gravitation potions and ores. That's about it. Okay. And the seaside trait, we got an inner tube, which lets you float on water, which I guess is kind of cool, but not what I wanted. We also got a lot of money from that. So that is the other thing, is we need more money so that we can get the Climentator. And, well, cure our problem over here with our desert pylon being corrupted. And then I'll have to probably, what I'll probably do is find a place and put some blocks so that they can't, the Crimson can't spread past it. I'll have to look into how to do that specifically, but yeah. So at this point, let's see if we can get the True Excalibur. Now that's going to require 20 chlorophyte, and we have way more than enough. Cool. So with that, we should be able to make True Excalibur, which is going to take us from 85 to 83, which sounds like a bad thing, but remember this has plus 8%, so superior. We have 92. That is pretty good. And Excalibur is also really nice because it shoots a projectile. And I don't know if the projectile pierces or not, but we'll find out soon enough. So yeah, all things considered, pretty good. Now we just need some souls. We can get True Knight's Edge, and then, well, we can go find Plantera, to be perfectly honest. I still would love to get some better accessories, and part of that is going to be getting the right potions, which I don't think we have, and I didn't make any potions, apologies. Danger sources, we want hunter potions, and battle potions might be good too. We'll keep that for now. So yeah, unfortunately we just don't have much of the stuff that we need. We can sell the archery potions though. Do not need those at all. I wish some of these guys would sell potions. I will say that's one of the most annoying things in this game, is making potions all the time. Mostly because I can never remember what's in a potion. So let's see if we could make a hunter potion. We have some bottled water. Where is the guide? How much money we got from the tax collector? 2 gold. We'll wait. So bottled water. Let's see. Danger sense, sonar, hunter, daybloom, shark fins. Of course, shark fins are annoying to get. Luck potions require pearls. That's annoying. Pearls are really hard to get. They come from oysters, and they have a very low chance of giving you the stuff you want. So armor cavefish, yeah. I need to get a lot of potion ingredients, but we're just gonna kind of go for it. I'm pseudo killing time until it's night. But actually, you know what? Let's grab the bottled waters and just bring them up here. You can also grab a water candle. So yeah, I guess right now all we really want to do is wait for night and then try to kill the destroyer. If we can kill the destroyer and get enough souls of might, we'll be able to make the True Knight's Edge. And I'm gonna actually put the chlorophyte away, the ingots anyways. This is getting full. Sort, that doesn't look nice. I need to either forget about the organization system or be a little bit better about it. You know what? We could sleep. Let's go ahead and sleep. And that will speed time up a little bit. So once it is night, which we're going to go to 8 p.m. I think 7 is good enough, but we'll go to 8. There is one other thing that we might want to get, which if we can would be awesome. If we can't, is kind of whatever. There is another weapon we can get from the solar eclipses that is really, really good. However, it requires solar eclipses. So let's go fight the destroyer. Do we want to use anything? Let's use the shine potion just to make things a little bit nicer. Let's eat. And you know, let's just go for it. So here comes the destroyer. And this should not be too difficult. We just gotta do some damage. Watch the lasers. And yeah, so the beam does not travel through enemies, but the destroyer is almost halfway dead. So we're weak, but we're actually doing pretty good. So let's just stand here. And yeah, we are almost done with the destroyer. Once you upgrade to the tier of like weaponry that they are, the mechanical bosses are not really that difficult. Alright, we need to be a little bit careful. Never mind. So we got 40 souls of might, some hollow bars, and that's it. We didn't get anything else. I don't know if the destroyer really drops anything else, but we didn't get anything else. And that did not take very long. It is what, like 9 o'clock? Yeah, 9 o'clock. Okay. So first of all, we could go ahead and make True Knight's Edge, which requires 20 of each and is pretty good. Does a lot of damage. It is 131 versus, wow, it is much better than True Excalibur. True Excalibur is kind of awful, to be perfectly honest. So we're going to put that away. So the final sword from this line, so True Knight's Edge and True Excalibur can be combined together, but we can't do that until after we defeat Plantera. It requires a solar eclipse enemy. That doesn't spawn until after Plantera is defeated. So that is a thing. But do we have enough souls to make an Avenger Emblem? We do. 12% increased damage, just flat out, 12%. That is really good. And I think it used, I used my Warrior Emblem. I didn't mean to do that. That's disappointing. Okay, so we have that if we want it. Now what can we use the Avenger Emblem for? Because I do believe it is useful. So, the Mechanical Glove, or the Destroyer Emblem, which we can't get until after we defeat, the Destroyer. So this is a good item. Can we wear it as a vanity? No. But we can put the Feral Claws aside for now. Our swing speed is considerably less. If we do this, we don't really need to have the extra jump against Plantera, I don't think. So let's see. Let's head down into, let's go to the underworld for just a moment. And what I want to do is I want to try to find some mimics. That would be really nice. But where is a good place? I think if we go here, we might be able to get into some more area that might be useful. So let's just continue using our Shine Potion. And yeah, this is going to put us into the desert, but that's okay. Let's head down a little bit. And, you know, maybe we'll find some things here that we can use. That was annoying, but there's a lot of lava down here. There's also just a sand chest lying out in the middle with a Thunder Zapper and a Splunker Potion. I guess we'll take all that stuff. and the sandstone chest. Because why not? So I want to just try to find kind of just an open cave. Hopefully we can find some mimics. That is the main idea. But looks like we're not going to have too much luck with just finding open caves. I kind of want to just go to the bottom and explore just a little bit, just to see. You know, maybe we will be able to find something. Maybe not. And this area is a little bit laggy. And we are getting into corrupted areas. And that's not a big deal, but it does mean, you know, annoying enemies, and all that kind of stuff. So try to get over here. That is a big worm. Wait, this is hollow? There's hollow here as well. What? Does this just have everything? Because that was a chaos elemental. But this is very much a corrupted sand biome. Alright, let's dig down just a little bit and kill things with cactuses. I just want to explore more than anything right now. I guess I do still have the shine potion effect. And I don't see anything of like value down here. So we might just bail and go to the jungle, which is what we honestly needed to do. But I wanted to see if we could explore just a little bit. There's so many accessories that we need to find that it would be nice to, you know, find them. We did get a lot of gold from there. And we're going to put the life roots over here. And actually, we're going to put this stuff in here. The souls we don't need as well. We can keep those in here. And alright, let's try to get rid of some of the stuff. Okay. So it's going to be important to remember not to just hit the buff button, because that's going to give me some bad buffs. But we need to find Plantera. If we want to defeat Plantera, we need to find Plantera. And that's not always easy. So first things first, we do have a shine potion. You know, actually, first things first, let's go back. Let's sharpen up. And I also want to... do we want to make... Can we make all of the hollow armor? No, we'll have to defeat one more boss. Do we dare go against Plantera with this armor? Honestly, I don't think that's a good idea. I don't think I put any hollow... No. We could make a piece of chlorophyte, though. Which would be better. If we can get a little bit more chlorophyte. So, I guess let's go ahead and go back to the jungle. We will dig around a little bit. I have Spelunker potions. And we'll see if we can't find a mimic. Mimics have a lot of the items that I currently want. But we're just going to kind of head down into the jungle, decently low. And then we'll pop the Spelunker potion and go from there. Now, Spelunker potions also show where... things like the life roots are. which will randomly grow in the jungle. And do some chlorophyte ore. Now, if you have just normal chlorophyte ore, it will spread. It's very, 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 very slow, but it will kind of spread in mud and, well, make more of itself, which is really cool. That's a really good thing, but it is very, very slow. All right, let's dig down. Let's go ahead and use a Spelunker potion. And you can see all of the wonderful things. Down here and grab this stuff. That is such a trap chest. I see the explosives. I see everything. Why do I feel like I've encountered this before? Anymore? There is. But it's a little bit farther away. We should be okay. Let's open it. Yep. It's a dead man's chest. I knew that. But I wanted to blow everything up because that is fun. So let's go ahead and grab some more chlorophyte. We can always make the chest plate out of chlorophyte and have mostly hollow but a little bit of chlorophyte armor. Now, the best armor that we can get as a melee character currently is turtle armor. Turtle armor is really good. However, it does require turtle shells, and we just don't have access to that right now. Well, speaking of which, this is how we get access to turtle shells, but it is a rare drop from the turtles. And that is not necessarily easy to come by. Interesting formation of chlorophyte there. So let's pick up the rest of this, and I guess we'll just kind of heading down. There is more chlorophyte. Always want more chlorophyte, but we are looking for Plantera's bulb. Now Plantera is, as you might guess, a plant. It is a flower. And we need to find the bulb to break so that we can spawn in. There's a trap here. I tried to get the tortoise with the trap, but it didn't work. There is a chest up here, though. Is this one trapped? Nope. Holding any type of, I almost called it redstone, wiring items, shows you all wiring items in the area. Restock. Okay. So that is something to kind of keep in mind. But is not a super, like, important thing. But you can see all the wiring when you're holding an item that is a wireable item. Which lets you see the traps pretty easy. Some areas are really nasty with, like, the wiring setup, but we'll get to the temple later. That is the worst place for all of that kind of stuff. Alright, so there is a fairy. We died down here at some point. But we can continue going down. Grab more chlorophyte ore. And flood a big area. Alright, I guess. Just kind of keep going down for right now. You do have to watch out for drowning, but we'll just go down. We dig relatively fast, so it's kind of nice. Alright. We still have shine? No. Let's get another shine potion. That is titanium. And there's a bunch of chlorophyte here. So, pick this up. But I'm not too worried about getting titanium. I mean, I guess I will. Why not? Let's get an air pocket. There we go. Okay. Some more. There is a glow over here. But it's nothing I care about. Okay. So we're now getting into the more underground area of the jungle, closer to like where the lava layer is what I'm trying to say. That is kind of bad. Also, it sounds like there is a Medusa. I'll take the gravitational potions. Why not? I have the healing potions back. I don't need those. More gravitation potions. Alright. There is another chest, I think. Seems to be. Don't really care. Another chest in here. And this one has a gold coin. That's about all I care about. Okay. So, yeah, our wow, there are so many chests down here. That's a mimic. That is something I've been looking for a long time. And we got another dual hook. That is awful. Man. You know, this might be a halfway decent place to get some stuff. Oh. Cool. Let's loot what we can. We're gonna put some stuff away. We're gonna take this stuff. Just because. Also, we can grab some more chlorophyte. And there is a glow over there, but I think that is the wrong color for what we're looking for. Namely, it looks like it's, it looks like it's for some crimtane. Or lava. Lava also works. There is another tree. There is more chests over here. I don't need these nature gifts. I got a depth meter. And I died. Wow. I wasn't paying attention to my health. So, let's do this. I am going to make some chlorophyte armor. We should have enough to pretty much make as much as we need. I mean, we have 50. We could probably make the entire set. Plate mail. Greaves. And the wrong kind of hat. Oh, that's a jungle hat. So we almost have enough for the entire, like, set. So how much money do we have? We should be pretty close. No, not really. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to step away. I am going to go get a bunch of things. I'm going to try to find some more mimics, get the items I want, and just kind of clean up the jungle even more. Get some more chlorophyte so that we can get the helmet. And we'll just forget about the hollowed set. We don't need it. So that is the plan. I'm going to do that. And I'll come back once I have that ready. And maybe even, you know, I will go ahead and make the helmet. And we'll just go ahead and find a Plantera bulb and go for it. Why not? So I'll be back once I've done all that. So a bit of a change of plans. There's a solar eclipse happening. So no Plantera today. But we're going to try to get a couple of good items. So we're just going to come over to our little arena area. There is one of the items that we could get. And I do have the chlorophyte armor. So we're going to go ahead and put that on, which gives us a sentry. Some of the powerful leaf crystal to shoot at nearby enemies. So that is really good. But yeah, basically, we're just going to now deal with the solar eclipse. I had no luck finding any more any Plantera bulbs, so that is unfortunate. And there is the enemy we want, the Reaper. The Reaper drops an item that is actually pretty good for fighting Plantera. But this is also a great way to get money. And I did find another mimic. Unfortunately, he dropped a magic item. The magic daggers, which are good weapons, but not what we need. So, yeah. Plantera will have to be next episode. Unfortunate, but I need to find a bulb before we can even think about fighting Plantera. One of the big things at this point is just trying to get the money to get the Clementator so we can make transportation between to the right side of the map a little bit easier. Ow, that was a vampire. I didn't realize that. And another. So yeah, we want Reapers. Hey, a broken bat wing. That is a wing material that I think is worse than what we currently have. I don't actually know. I did find, by the way, in the jungle while I was mining and exploring, I did find the rare mob, a moth. Didn't have anything that I wanted. Didn't drop anything, which it's a 50% chance to drop the... what does it drop? The butterfly dust, I think, to give you the butterfly wings. I believe the bat wing is the same tier as what we have. I actually don't remember. I looked this stuff up because I never know which wings are best. I usually get the thin wings from the angler and just call that a day. But I'm not having any luck with the Reapers. It is like a relatively low chance, but not like super low chance for them to drop their weapon. But if we can get it, it'd be really nice. Otherwise, yeah, we got the Neptune Shell, which makes water maneuvering a lot easier. And it's used for some good weapons, or good accessories, rather. I don't know if they're good for us, being a melee class, but they're good in general. So, yeah. The Solar Eclipse, that's not much to say about it. I will say, you guys have seen this before, we did one of these on camera not too long ago, so I'm probably going to do this one off camera as well, especially if I get the drop, then I'm going to kind of forget about it and hightail it out of here. I've also found a couple more life fruits, so let's go ahead and use those. We can get 20 more life. So I will keep an eye out for more of the life fruits. That is a thing. You know what? It would be nice. We gotta go back to our base. But if we want to farm items from this, let's make it easier for things to spawn. I don't know if it actually affects it, but let's go ahead and grab... I put it in here. I empty out a lot of my inventory. But, head back now. We are going to get a good bit of money from this, which is nice. We need the money to buy the Clementator, so that we can Clementate and get rid of some crimson. But let's go ahead and put a water candle down and see if that actually affects anything. If I start getting overwhelmed, which I shouldn't, there's a moonstone. That is really good. Worn during the night grants minor increase to damage, melee speed, just minor buffs. During the night, it is a really good item. It can be combined with another item once we defeat the golem, and is in general just really good. This feels like more enemies. I don't know if it is, but it feels like it. So yeah, I am going to go ahead and call the episode here. I'm going to finish up this solar eclipse, and I am going to search for mimics as well as Plantera's bulb so that next episode we can defeat another boss and go from there. So I'll see if I can get the Reaper's weapon. It is a really good weapon if I can. Like I said, it is really good for Plantera. Otherwise, we'll just use the True Knight's Edge. But yeah, that is going to be it for this episode. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Unfortunately, we didn't get to beat a boss today, but we did get some upgrades, both in our weapons and our armor, so that is nice. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this, and I will see you guys in the next episode. Bye!